are two great tastes that taste great together. They've been voicing Obi-Wan and Anakin for years now, and they're here to say...
Hello there.
Give it up for Matt Lanter and James Arnold Taylor.
I don't know why he got a lightsaber and I didn't.
Hello there. Hello there.
I think that's why. I think that might be why. We also love our Anakin Skywalker, don't we?
Yes, we do.
Of course we do. All right, hello there.
Hello there.
How are you both?
We're wonderful. We're at Star Wars Celebration in London.
You two are far from first-timers to Star Wars Celebration.
No, we both have been to many Star Wars Celebrations. In fact, I hosted two Star Wars Celebrations on the main stage and had a fantastic time, but nothing like what you all have done now. I love what you've done with the place.
I've been celebrating Star Wars since I got the gig, so...
And probably before.
And before.
Yes, he really is the chosen one, because he got to go to George Lucas's private office and see him and hang out with the man himself. It was pretty cool. He's had some wonderful Star Wars experiences.
Let's talk a little bit more about that. So now, great segue.
I set you up.
Now, you've both gotten the chance to work with George Lucas and Dave Filoni.
Yes, the other chosen one,
Dave Filoni. Yes, the master and the apprentice at one point, but, you know, Dave Filoni's certainly a master now in his own right.
Isn't he, though? How cool is it? Dave is going to be making a Star Wars movie, huh? The moment we waited for! Awesome!
We love to see it. But now you've been working with both of them for quite a while, or you did work with them for quite a while. How have all of those years of experience with George and then with Dave changed your perspective on Star Wars?
Oh, I mean, it's amazing. So every time we went in to record the Clone Wars, Dave would sit there and talk for, it was probably half hour at least. It's amazing got work done.
That checks out.
He would sit there, aside from laughing, he would sit there and talk about Star Wars and where the characters were and just kind of share his storytelling, which... he learned from George. So it was a pretty cool experience for
us. It was those moments where we would be recording an episode, and he's through the glass, and he's on the phone. And then he hangs up the phone and says, okay, George just said, and we're like, wait a second. George, yes. And it was so great to watch that, to see what he got to learn from the master and what he has taken and made so wonderfully now with everything he's doing.
I feel like I've learned a lot about character from Dave. It's amazing time.
Being and sketch. He's a great artist. So, Dave would sketch characters as we're going. So he would draw little Ahsokas for Ashley and things and then give them to her. Now, she's got to hold on to those. Those are worth a fortune now, I'm sure. So.
I'm sure. I think we have one on the back of our door, actually, over there. Now, it's the 15th anniversary of the Clone Wars, which I find to be staggering. I can't believe it's been that long. It's amazing. Matt, do you have a favorite moment from making the Clone Wars, either together or just in general?
Some of my favorite moments from the Clone Wars are moments like this, you know, where we're all on stage, we're all just celebrating the Clone Wars and Star Wars in general, and traveling with these guys, being up at the ranch, and seeing the joy that it brings on people's faces. People come up to, us and just talk about it. It was my childhood or some traumatic event happened, but the Clone Wars got them through. Those are the little meaningful things that you don't forget. So along with enjoying it, I mean, it's really, it brings people through tough times and Those are the really, really cool things to hear.
And it brings people together.
It does, yeah.
It does.
What about for you, James?
Oh, I would wholeheartedly agree with what Matt said. I mean, it's a life-changing experience to be a part of it. You know, I saw Star Wars. I'm the old man in the room right now. But I saw Star Wars when I was 7 years old in a drive-in movie theater. Changed my life. Never thought that one day I'd get to be old Obi-Wan. Now, I think I'm one of the only people, if not the only person here, that was actually in the first Clone Wars. So if you see those 20 years, Clone Wars 20, that's because the micro series of the Clone Wars, and I was Obi-Wan in that. That was the first time I got to play Obi-Wan. So.
Got some fans of the micro series.
Yeah.
Now, looking back on all that work that you've both done as Obi-Wan, as Anakin, Sky Guy, what are you most proud of as your part of the legacy for these characters who are just larger than life in the Star Wars galaxy?
I think that in the Clone Wars, we got to see Anakin a little different than we did in the films. And I feel like George and Dave wanted to take the Clone Wars time to sort of expand the character of Anakin and make him a hero that we really, really loved. And so when he falls and he becomes Darth Vader, I feel like it's that much more sad. It's so much more tragic because you rooted for this guy. You cared for him. And it also adds more to his story as to why he turned and the loss of Ahsoka, which is something we didn't know about. So I think all of that, it's been such a joy to just add to that character and make him so much more rich than he already was.
Yeah, I totally agree. I mean, Hayden and Matt complement each other so much, this character of Anakin Skywalker, and they bring so much to it. And I'm honored to get to work with this guy on a regular basis. He's an amazing actor, a wonderful friend. And we live near each other, and he actually lives on a big hill now just so he can say, I have the high ground. It's not fair.
It's true, I have the high ground.
And that would say, I would say for me, bringing the sass to Obi-Wan Kenobi has been the funnest, yes. I love that. So.
I love the sass, and I love the way you just slip into the voice there.
Yes.
And tell that it's good. It's real good. I didn't hear that.
We got a shout-out. I don't know what
we got a shout-out of some kind, but you're quoting all these wonderful quotable quotes. Is there a line from the show that is less quotable and more haunting because it was really difficult to get out in the moment?
You got one?
It's not difficult to get out necessarily, but Anakin says something like, this might not even be verbatim, but something like, I realize, more than you know, I realize what it's like wanting to leave the Order. And that says so much to me.
Oh, I can see the episode. I can see it. Yeah.
And it's something that we've never really seen Anakin kind of voice, that he's sort of is handcuffed. He's kind of felt chained, and he's sort of voiced that to Ahsoka. That was such an intimate moment that I loved that moment.
It takes strength to resist the dark side. Only the weak embrace it.
That's a good one. Now, why is that one haunting you?
Well, that episode was haunting for me. So we would get the scripts when we walked in the room. I did not know. Spoiler alert. I think it's Star Wars Celebration. It's okay to say. Season 5, Satine, I did not know what was going to happen. So when Obi-Wan says Satine under his breath, those were little ad-libs. Those were moments that would just happen because it was heart-wrenching to be there and to be a part of that. So yeah, those moments are haunting because I also think Obi-Wan is a true believer. He wanted to see if he could save Darth Maul. He really believed that there was a chance with Ventress or with any of these people that he could maybe save them. Or any of these people. You were my brother!
Any of these people. Who are you talking about?
Get over it.
Now, you mentioned before, you know, just how important the Clone Wars is to a lot of fans out there. People grew up with it. It got them through difficult times. Is there anything you want to say to everyone who has been with the Clone Wars for the majority of or the entirety of this 15-year process, you know, with these stories and with your characters?
Thank you all. You all saved Clone Wars.
Yeah,
all
absolutely.
Of you. Yeah. You all saved Clone Wars. We love you. We truly love you and thank you.
Yeah.
From the bottom of our hearts, I mean that.
You guys embraced the Clone Wars, and now we've got 7 spectacular seasons of Star Wars content that just adds to the saga and makes it so much more rich. And I mean, to be a part of that and to feel the love from you guys and the warmth, it's pretty amazing. And yeah, I just think it's great to be able to celebrate, you know, Clone Wars on its anniversary and just Star Wars in general. It's just amazing to be here.
Well, that is how we rang in the 10-year anniversary with the surprise of Clone Wars saved. I remember that quite vividly at, I think, San Diego Comic-Con.
Yeah, that
it was just supposed to be an anniversary panel.
We never thought that it would come back, truly. None of us did. So it was fantastic to see that panel. The explosion from everybody there was fantastic, yeah.
How emotional was it then for you to also come back and step into those roles again?
Do you want to?
Well, I mean, for me, I never, people ask me this all the time. What was it like to come back? But I feel like I never really put Anakin down. I mean, we're always doing video games or, you know, special little projects here and there. And also, I mean, honestly, like, Anakin is a part of me. We've been doing it now for 17
years, because we started 2 years prior to it coming out. Yeah.
Yeah, so, I mean, I had a Star Wars wedding, you know? shout out to my wife, if you're watching back in the States. You know, so it's a part of me now, and it always has been. So I never really let it go. But it was great to come back and be with these guys and be in the booth again, for sure.
We were in the same studio that we recorded originally, so it was very magical. I remember the last time we did a scene together was Ashley and myself and Dee and Matt. And Dave goes, we got it the first time. Let's just do it again because it's fun to watch you guys. So we did it like 2 or 3 more times. And that was the energy of it, because we're just really a family. We truly are a family, and we just love being a part of it all.
So I can tell in all the photos that you all take on the convention circuit now.
We tend to goof off a little bit.
Yeah, a little. Just a tiny bit. I wasn't going to call it out. But, speaking of fun, it's always fun to have you two here to hang out with, to talk about Star Wars. We love having you. Thank you so much for everything
that you do for Star Wars
and the Clone Wars and the fandom. We've got lots more to come today on Star Wars Celebration Live. Don't you go anywhere.